Okay, so we just spent a lot of time talking about how to use hashing and the HMAC variant of hashing to make cookies that won't be tampered with. Let's talk about using passwords for hashing. So say we have a table for users in our database, and this table has a couple columns. One column is for the user's name, and another column is for the user's password. If we wanted to verify a user is valid, we might have a function that looks like this. You know, and this would get called when somebody logs in, and it'd probably say like user, you know, equals get user, where this is some function that gets the user from the database. And then we'd say, you know, so if this user exists and this user's password equals PW, what was passed in, return user. And that's simple enough. Now, the problem with this approach is that if your database gets compromised, you are in trouble. You gave away all of your users' passwords. Which means not only are your users angry because you compromised their privacy, your website is in trouble because you've got bad guys logging in, screwing around with all people's accounts because they know everybody's passwords. So that's a really bad situation. So what we want to do is instead of storing these plain text passwords in our database, we'll store password hash in our database. So we'll have H of Hunter 2 and H of Metallica. And if our database gets compromised, all the attacker has is a bunch of password hashes. And you know it's very, very difficult, basically impossible, to turn the hash of this into the actual input parameter. This function changes a little bit. So instead of just comparing PW to the password field in the database, we compare hash of PW to the password hash in the database. And all of a sudden, we're in a much better situation. This takes very little work, and your database doesn't have any plain text passwords in it. And if your database does get compromised, all the attacker has is a bunch of hashes and not a bunch of valuable passwords. So this is a very important strategy that you should employ when building user registration systems, such as in this week's homework. But before we get there, let's do a quiz.